Hello. Once again, I am Felicia.
And once again, I'm Giancarlo.
And this is our review of...
Mini Rails. The little game about trains.
It's
not that little. I mean, it's got some tactics.
The artwork is...
very...
this is very nice.
Yes.
I just read that Mini Rails is light.
It's light. Are you going to open every game? Because then I have to put it back. You dropped the shit on the floor. Today you haven't.
You're a little hyper. I need to pipe down. Mini Rails. Next.
Players take on the role of wealthy investors in Mini Rails. The player with the most points at the end of the sixth round wins. The game is set with turn order track as such for the first round. Player orders determine from left to right. On their turn, the active player will move their pawn onto any available colored disc on the turn track and do one of two possible actions. They can either buy a share by placing the disc on the zero space and moving their stock certificate off the board, which means they cannot do this action again this round, or build a track by moving their train tile off the board, meaning the only other action this round is buy stocks, and placing the disc adjacent to another same colored one on the board. Placing them over white dots will move all stocks of that color up on all the player boards equal to the dots quantity on that space. Placing it on red dots will decrease those same colored stocks on all player boards as the quantity of dots on that space.
When all players have taken their two different actions, one disc will remain. This will go down onto the taxed area, denoting the end of the current round. A new round will begin with the new player order, and discs will randomly be pulled from the bag to fill the spaces. When the last disc fills up the last taxed space at the end of the sixth round, we trigger the end game. All companies that have at least one disc in the taxed area have all their discs removed in the loss area on the player boards. Each company that has no disc in the taxed area removes all their discs in the profit zone on each player board. Total up the value of each stock you own, and the player with the most wins.
Mini Rails is a light, small Euro game that I would actually class as a filler. It plays fairly quick and smoothly and does pack a lot of tactics. That said, interestingly enough, there is actually a lot of chaos going on from other player actions to what discs come out to make it strategically viable. Even with all company discs having been placed in the bag equally, the luck factor may have you either see too many or not enough in one given round. So it's really hard to plan for that. Most often than not, two players will have the same company shares and protect their interest, while driving down the share value of the other players. Many a game, someone was left in a kingmaker position. Moe Dea's game design so far has provided great quality components, and they implement the theme and the mechanics. Building rails and mountains will always be more costly for a company, a loss of 3 points, while bringing your rails to suburbs or cities will skyrocket your profit. The game does handle scaling well mechanically with counted discs placed in the bag and starting discs on the board, but we found a higher player count does play better, for another half point penalty. Full pro points goes to the modular double-sided boards that will make every game of Mini Rails different. I love to see what Moe Dea has in store for us with Tulip Bubble, which we'll review soon, but Mini Rails slightly missed the mark for us, and gets a score of 6 out of 10. Subscribe now to our channel to stay in the loop. If you like our work, help us continue by sharing the channel to your gaming group. Thanks for watching and happy gaming.